Racket number one. Does a looming economic recession mean bad things for our real estate values? So I want to frame this up using a Real Deal article, which we'll link up. We've got two links for this topic, the Real Deal article and then some KCM stuff, which we'll get into here in a minute.
Does everybody know what KCM is?
Keeping Current Matters. So that's Steve Harney. I actually got to talk to Steve a little bit in the hotel lobby at the Marriott.
That sounds like a magical moment.
And that was a magical moment for me personally. Steve also shared with over 5,000 agents at the Tom Ferry Summit some of his thoughts on a looming recession. Obviously, a great week to talk about it because the stock market took a complete bath last week. We'll see what happens here as we get into this week.
I enjoy him on Instagram.
He's great.
He's like, it's nothing fancy.
No.
It's nothing
but it's
fancy.
Good, hard info.
I really enjoy his voice.
Yeah.
I'm a big voice.
He's a New Yorker.
Yeah, it works for me.
So
the
Real Deal article, you can stop in like the second paragraph because they talk about these economic jolts that are going to hit the real estate industry hard hasn't really happened yet. So they're predicting things without a ton of data, although they do get into some pretty good data when they talk about commercial real estate. There was two quarters in a row where we had a decline in a commercial. And I do think, you know, when we start talking about an economic recession, commercial this time around makes a lot more sense to me to take a big hit, not multifamily commercial, but retail commercial than anything else. Just because who will an economic recession this time around as we get into going into 2020, who will that impact the most? It's probably going to be all these companies that have fallen to Amazon over the last decade.
Right. So why keep opening like additional locations?
So the brick and mortar around commercial retail, that could be a concern. I want to talk about what Steve said to the audience at the Tom Ferry Summit.
Oh, you took some notes.
And I took some notes. And one thing I'll point out, we're in the longest recovery ever in U.S. history.
Certain of that.
So this last 10 years is a recovery from our last recession, right? Our last recession, which was 2008. This is the longest recovery ever. So you would only imagine in that case that we're going to see now a recession. What does a recession mean? A recession is two consecutive quarters where the GDP slips. All right? So it is not housing pricing.
Right.
It's nothing other than two consecutive back-to-back quarters where the GDP slips. We haven't seen that yet in America. So there are five countries that if you're headline reading and you're on CNN Money or CNBC or any of these places, you probably did see that headline. There are five global economies that are now into a recession because what happened was they had two consecutive quarters where their GDP slipped. So that's a recession. Now, how will a recession impact our housing market, our home values? Because that's ultimately what we care about.
Well, that's what, and all, not just us. I mean, everybody.
But for our clients,
of
like
course.
Dealing with their,
yes.
their
homeowners
homes.
Homeowners are always worried about, yes.
They think or they read recession in a headline with home values and automatically assume bad.
Well, it's because we all have, I think, a little bit of like post-traumatic stress syndrome.
From 2008.
Yes. Yeah.
So we're going to put up a graphic here, Suave, and leave it up for a little bit. I think it's an important graphic for people to really absorb, understand. And when you look at our last one, 2008, yeah, our home values went down 19.7%. But let's look at the four recessions before that. In 1980, we actually went up.
Oh,
our
you
home
drew
values
it.
Went up.
You drew it.
I drew it on my notes here. Yeah, but the graphic that they're looking at is much better than my
you
notes.
You couldn't take your phone out and just snap a photo?
I could have, but I would never look at that again.
No, that's
you
a
always.
Shame.
I saw so many people taking photo after photo,
of all
and
the
you
slides.
See it at every conference, at every slide. And then I actually was sitting next to Eric, the BA, the broke agent. Who's missing you, by the way.
Yeah, was he? Were you guys in the front? I feel like you were close to in the front.
Sometimes. And this particular time we were in the back, so we saw everybody.
So he was able to afford like those kinds of seats?
No, he couldn't.
Remember last time
it.
You had to smuggle me in?
He got a all access pass.
He
we
did?
That, yeah.
How?
Well, he's the BA.
Wow. You know? I wouldn't have. I probably would have been in the back without the table.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, he had the legit setup.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're sitting there, and I said to him, I said, Eric, nobody is, 99% of the room is never going to look at these slides again. Like, they're never going to go
was
that far back
photos?
In the photos. No. He was like Instagramming or something.
I'm sure.
All right. So 1980, 6.1% increase in home values. Mm-hmm. 1981, so the next year there was another recession. So there was another back-to-back consecutive quarter of the GDP slipping. Mm-hmm. Again, home values went up in 81, 3.5%.
You know what's really funny? Look what I did this morning. I screenshotted it. Look, I screenshotted it.
Okay,
I feel like I'm one
you.
Of those people that were there. That
so Nicole can help us. In 1991, what happened?
Well, you're talking about 1981 and then 1991.
81, it went up 3.5%. Yes. 91, it went down 1.9%.
It did. Mm-hmm.
And then in 2001, it went up 6.6%. So those previous four recessions, you could argue, because 91 went down 1.9%.
That's still pretty flat, though, man.
It's pretty flat. You could argue that it was either flat or an increase in four of the last five economic recessions. Mm-hmm. Now, we went down 19.7% in 2008, so you could say, well, I don't want to get in that situation.
Never.
But what was different about that situation than the other four?
Go ahead. We're all dying
here. It's like
a
quiz. You and I were just talking about
this.
We
were. Oh, you want me to answer it?
Yeah.
I thought that was like a rhetorical.
Well, I was looking at you.
Oh, go ahead. You keep going.
All right. The big difference between 2008 and these previous four recessions is 2008's recession was driven by a mortgage and housing crisis.
Crisis.
Steve Harney, owner of KCM, he brought up a Realtor.com survey. And Realtor.com went out and surveyed, you know, all of their...
You love Realtor.com.
I do. Mm-hmm. And they surveyed a bunch of their, you know, people that are using their website. Mm-hmm. A bunch of their traffic, right?
So many people.
And all the people out
all
there.
All of them.
And so the consumers, when asked, ranked real estate as the 9th reason of why we would fall into a recession or a looming recession mm-hmm. would happen. There were 8 other examples that consumers, homeowners, pointed to as the reason why they feel like we would slip potentially into an economic recession. Stock, inflated stocks, mm-hmm. right?
I do. The only thing that I want to say that goes along with that, and this is just me, is that I agree that people are feeling like, because I don't feel like the recession will happen because of housing, especially where we are. There's nothing inflated. There's no big balloons here. Like, we're not.
When you look at the data that and listen to Steve Harney,
yeah.
you know, national economist,
yeah,
really global economist, he's talking about there not being data to support a housing crisis right now.
Right. So my point is, though, is that based on that, the question, it sounds like what was the question that was on Realtor.com? What did they ask the people?
They asked,
what is going to cause a recession?
And these are in
so
consumers' opinions.
Because I feel like as a consumer, I'm not necessarily concerned with housing causing a recession. I'm just always concerned with housing during a recession. So these numbers are actually extremely helpful for me to see, too, even as a real estate professional, because I've never really, to be honest, looked at them. So
well,
thank
these
you,
are
Steve.
The home values of what happened during that
recession. No, that's
recession
what I'm saying, because typically you think that during a recession – prices are going to decrease. I mean, that's just your innate concern.
And so the big point that I think is important, if you're an agent and you're relaying information to your consumers, and this is the point that Steve made, is that there is a big difference between a economic recession and a housing crisis.
Right.
In fact, those are two completely different things.
Yes. And most agents, including myself, I mean, I wasn't even an agent during the last recession. I just remember what happened to housing.
Yeah.
But it was because it was really housing caused it.
And that one,
right.
Housing caused it. So
right.
It's when. Like, we will have a 2-quarter period where the GDP slips because it's, you know, especially with where we've been, 10 years of recovery, mm-hmm. it is absolutely going to happen, and healthy for it to happen, for there to be recession. But as homeowners or as agents speaking to homeowners, it's important for us to remember that every economic recession is different from the last, right? Or could be different from the last. and to separate the two. Housing crisis, recession, two different things.
Right.
Let's look at them both. Let's look at what's driving this one, mm-hmm. and let's look at what's actually driving the housing market, and they may go completely different directions.
It's good. It's good information, I have to say.
We'll be talking more about that because, listen, I mean, we don't talk about politics on this show, but Never. Steve made a great point. There is going to be a ton of headlines over the next, you know, 12 months or 15 months, whenever, you know, between now and November 2020, there are going to be a lot of headlines that want to tear down the economy. And then there's going to be a lot of headlines that want to really, you know, put the economy of the last 4 years on a pedestal, mm-hmm. depending on who's writing
the article.
Of course.
Well, that's, I mean, that's every election year.
So you're going to look at headlines and you're going to see the most extreme version of the truth. And to Steve's point, like CNN Money and CNBC and Fox Business, like any of these types of sources are driving clickbait to their political agendas and are probably not the source to actually get the information of what's happening in the economy. I'm going to really start to dig in as an agent into KCM, Keeping Current Matters, mm-hmm. as much as I possibly can so that I can be educated for my clients.
Well, I think it's also helpful, though, too, because people are relying on you to be an information source, you need to not be flustered by the headlines.
You need
too.
To be able to combat the headlines because your clients are no doubt reading those headlines. They don't know what Keeping Current Matters. Not every homeowner knows or would even subscribe to Keeping Current Matters because they don't need to. That information is not relevant on a day-to-day basis to what they do.
Yeah.
The Ivy Zelman report, it's one that Tom Ferry pushes a lot, something that's, you know, a little bit more advanced, I think, than what KCM is. KCM is really breaking it down so you can relay the information to your consumer in a beautiful, understandable fashion.
Beautiful.
Ivy Zelman is really going into, like, these long form
words.
Reports.
Yeah, I don't
lots
like words.
Of words, Nicole.
I don't do words.
But that's where, as agents, we need to focus on what is actually happening. Get away from the headlines. I know on this show we like to do headlines.
No, well, but there's multiple times though too where we said that the headline
doesn't match
the
up.
The article was nothing about the headline. So. All right.